Welcome all SMC Soccer at Lunch fans. In this video, the class of 2022 Soccer at Lunch boys all sat down together and reviewed and rated each individual's player's season from 0 to 10. Unfortunately, due to technical difficulties, we did lose the footage of the boys rating and reviewing the first two draft picks. That is why you are left with this shitty voiceover. The first pick of the draft, Trihard selected Ryan Finlay. The Heroes then responded by drafting Bodie Sims. With an amazingly consistent season, Ryan Finlay proved why he was the number one pick. With his amazing ball skills and his high IQ plays, he showed why he was a huge part of the Trihard success this season. Ryan Finlay had an incredible season, with all the boys agreeing with a rating of a 9. The second pick of the draft, the Hero selected Bodie Sims. A brick wall in defence and just an overall machine. Throughout the season, Bodie Sims has been the backbone of the Hero side, at times having to stand up in the absence of their captain, Callum Caputo, while he does whatever the fuck he does in the Year 12 centre while his side take battle in the cage. Bodie's stellar season saw him receive a rating of a 10 from the Soccer at Lunch committee. That's it from this shit voiceover. Enjoy the video.
He's very good for a confident high, as a third draft pick,
I'm
going to
rate him
a 6.
He's got a lot of goals.
Let's be fair, he's kicked a lot of goals.
But we rate that season on the value.
He did have those couple of weeks.
Stat pad sometimes.
Yeah, he's a good stat.
I think he could have put him in later.
Like, you could say
he's down, he's kicked one, celebrates, like he's on the Champions League.
Yeah, and he gets bullied around by Tommy Hunter, like, every
time. He does.
Tommy does.
He gives him a bar.
So we'll give Team Money a 6.
Even Binger Allen will turn on.
I reckon Anton has improved dramatically since last season.
What about his goal yesterday?
I reckon at the start of the year he was adjusting from normal soccer to soccer, but as he's gone through, he just got better and better.
I did sleep on him as a pick because last season I had him on my team, but I yelled at him every lunch.
I can see some potential in this lad, and he's really lived up to it.
And he overcome a pretty serious injury at the start of the year.
Yeah.
But he used it to his advantage, you don't know.
His career was nearly over.
He crashed.
Yeah.
His season crashed, but then he regretted it. He had a car to show for it, and he used the car well.
He's a driving force.
He caused some stench.
Nah, he's had a solid season, and so I've got a fair play. What do you reckon?
Eight?
I'd go eight.
I'd personally give him a 10, but that's just as his teammate.
That's just Heroes fucking tried it off for a change.
Unfortunately, a W pick.
He's got skill, but his effort.
The consistency isn't there.
Effort 10 out of 10. And if you're 10 out of 10.
If you remember, when we picked him, we expected to give up Pagey, but we ended up getting both.
Ah, spoiler.
Well, okay, we ended up getting both.
Yeah.
Webby, he's
not very coordinated, but his effort is everywhere. And we try hard, so we want effort. And I reckon he's given that up.
Yeah.
I'm giving that up all year. So, what do we think, though?
I'd say 7.
7?
I'd say 8.
7 or 8.
He's been the main
defender. He has. He's put in a lot of shit, a lot of running.
And he doesn't like, a lot of people get greedy up forward. He never tries to go up forward.
Fuck it, he's an 8.
He's always a sweeper back there. Like,
If ever, no, I'd say push up. I'd say.
We'll chuck an 8. I was surprised when he went that early, Luke Coleman.
He's been a solid defender, really.
He has.
And keep it.
He can use his feet, he can use his knees.
I think best of all his tactical side, where he, like, when he knows when to play it safe and when to boot it.
He's a dog.
We'll just get to about his ability to kick the ball over the fence, but he's improved on it.
But it's proved
the ability is proved.
See, what kick six? What did you go at?
What six?
Well, Mike.
No.
Are we rating me off my pick or not?
Well, we have been workhorse all year, you know. You know, it's
I think it's similar to a
child head ball sometimes, but it's okay.
Well, I don't think. I have a 7.
I'll go off his season 8, but from the peak, probably 7. So we go to a 7.
I got 7.
That was huge. Good game, bro. That was huge. I can't
believe we did that still.
Well, I'm his biggest critic by far.
Definitely.
He's unreal. So I'm going to say as he pulls off. He saved us a lot of games. Cost us a couple, but he saved more.
I'll give him a 9.
Yeah, I'll give him a 9.
He's a solid 9.
He's won some games for us.
Valencia's won a lot of games for us.
He'll play a huge part for us come Grand Final day, so hopefully he can rock up. Let's go.
Start the year 9, end the year 3.
Yeah, agree. As the seasons progressed, we had a few blind trades throughout the season, and Sam did end up becoming a try hard, which us tryhards appreciate.
Sam was an amazing keeper. His aerial ability was just
His goal being
attacking
and his effort
when he would come out field. Like, he'll at least get the goal, he provided everything for us, but then sadly he had to leave us in the blind trade.
And when he left, I don't think he's been the same, honestly.
He brings a heap of energy to the field when he's out, and he's taking the game serious enough and being a flop. He brings that much excitement to the team, and we've loved having him since winning in the blind trade, but I reckon I'd give Sam an 8.
He's an L bloke, but
I'd hate it to come up against Adam White, kicking his shins,
he does is insult my ankle.
We didn't want to
probably
face that.
Probably 6 foot and play real. If he even played every game, would have been.
We're forgetting how little he actually played, he cracked the shits early in the year.
When he was having a little power.
He stole it. As I'm sure you'll hear more about, he did steal the ball that we were giving away.
Being a simp as well.
However, now though, he's been good.
He's valuable, but what do we reckon?
6, 5, 1. He does make some silly decisions in game, but listening to the opponents when they said
6, but 8 if he played.
I'd say 5 because I'm sick of those fucking flying knees when the ball's coming in.
And when he just listens to Callum mid
game.
He does get well.
Could have had 5.
He's an absolute workhorse.
Cheat as well.
Nah, he's good. He's got a bit of coordination, he's not the most uncoordinated. And he runs his guts out for the team, and I'll play against him this year.
At 11, that's
fine. Yeah, sometimes he thinks he's got the technique and name on him, yeah. But, you know, he was in the tech boardroom.
Yeah. He struggled with his schoolwork, but he always found a way to get out at lunch, which we appreciate. But for pick 11, I reckon that's pretty good.
That's a steal. Right. When he plays,
what as of late, he's been able
to play. What about an 8.5
yeah.
for
the back? Yeah,
Marsh. Yeah, no, well done, Marsh. Just not good enough.
He's just wrecked the culture the whole year. When he plays,
look,
he did have a distraction.
He's done some tricks.
He's kicked a lot of goals, but he has off more than he's kicked goals. Mm.
Yeah. We do love him at tries, though. We'd rather, in saying all this, we would prefer him to be on our team than the other team, I reckon.
I think his tree trunk injury damages him.
He did have a little ankle injury, which resulted in a moon boot for 2 days. he connects to some good shots, he does score some crucial
goals. Ryan Vial would have had the most shots in soccer at once history.
Yeah.
Especially volleys that have just... Not going to
the I think he would have the most backheel attempts as well.
He doesn't leave a spot. Yeah.
But he counts his stats. You ask him to tell you how many assists he had.
And he will turn on grand final.
Grand final day.
Yeah, he will. Yeah, he'll have that loss again.
What do we reckon? What? I will bring to light his enthusiasm. He doesn't rock up to many games, does he?
But when he's out there,
he does give Tyson a laugh. Oh, Tyson's worst nightmare.
Yeah, every day.
I don't know.
He's physical night. He's physical night.
And that school won a goal of the season as well.
Yeah. Oh, that was actually beautiful.
He loves body on body, like.
He can hold the point off very well and slow the play down.
Yeah. He's just got the smarts, 300 data.
If there was real umpiring, I believe there would be many more free kicks played.
Against you. Let's not get political, but I reckon Tommy Hunter, when he's come out, he needed to be a bit more into it, I reckon. He likes sitting next to Bo on that little air conditioner.
He's definitely a hero.
Six. Oh, Tommy's a 6.5.
He's a W man.
When he's on, he's on. He also spent, it was a great pick.
Fucking heaps of Aries though.
Also spent a bit of time in the wood room.
Yeah, I don't know how his knees made it through this year with all these Aries.
Like, he's kicked some goals, like, I don't know how. He just kicked them.
He's very good for a goal, like.
Sometimes, yeah.
Coordination's not there. Passing's not there.
He
just builds the ball and it finds the net.
He plays mind games. So
he's always forward from Matt.
Pass the ball to him. Sometimes Marshall does.
Yeah, he was on both teams for a bit. Don't know what happened there, but no, he's been a great
player. Oh, what are we? I'd give him an 8.
Yeah. 8.
Mm-hmm. For pick 11.
Yeah. No, it's 4-9. Nice number.
4-9.
4-9. College does it still.
Yeah. Nah, well done.
Yes.
Well, he was supposed to be a goalkeeper.
Well,
he did get more.
He
got
the most player of the week.
First
man of the league. That's where it paid.
That's where he got the curse. He got the curse.
Can I add, it was a 2-day week. Yeah, he got the player
of the week curse for the entire rest of the year.
Yeah.
I think we, yeah. Nah, but he's been passing around each team like before this year.
Yeah, I said that.
And
we appreciate it.
He plays with no shoes on. And he looks silly like skipping around, but he's done some good.
His legs are just too long.
I'd say 10 for effort.
No.
But 3 for execution.
Sometimes.
Yeah. I reckon his arm still wasn't here.
I think in pay uniform he's a 10.
Yeah, with shoes on, this guy.
He's a freak.
Nah, we like it. We want you on our team. We'd rather you with us. So you're saying that for?
He also did a bit of keeping for, you know, like, obviously it started a bit later, you know, you did alright, the open hand slaps.
Have to go out on mental health breakout.
What do we reckon? Six and a half?
Yeah. I reckon 7.
Nah.
6 3/4.
It's been very good.
Six and a half.
Has he been the same or worse than Thomas here, I think?
Better. Oh, he's better.
Six point nine. When he did play,
he was referred to as a fail pedal at the start of the year for his weak performance. But sadly, he did do his ACL, meaning that he could no longer continue the season.
He did his ACL.
Yeah, so he did his ACL and without people knowing he did his ACL, the try hard got a trade. So we got rid of him and made a player out of it. But, he did nothing. He's had the ACL.
He had a lot of chances. He had some of the most misses of the season.
When he played, he was on track for worst player.
I think he did have the worst miss of the season, and he only played 2 weeks. So.
Give him a 2.
For a soccer player.
Two for his 2 weeks he played a lot.
Yeah, that's fair.
Alright, well, yeah.
I think he did better after his ACL.
Because he played.
Nah, well played, Ryan.
You're telling me to
don't you could.
There was that one game where he kicked that, you know, he took some amazing goal, but it hasn't really said it since.
I haven't got much to say.
He always tries to go back here a bit.
I reckon, alright.
He's got the sport in his blood, but he doesn't show on the field.
He's got the politics in his blood as well. He is the Prime Minister.
He is the Prime Minister.
Yeah, he's been up in Canberra most of the season.
My only complaint
is when he does get ball, he does like to square it back
in the middle. Yeah.
His effort's
pretty good.
He's
solid.
I'll go six.
If
you go 6.9, that low, I'm willing to give you a 7.
I'd
say he's better than Logan.
What was Logan?
6.9.
6.9.
Would you give
him
a
7
or
no? Oh,
yeah.
This is playing
well.
No, but Logan
Pyro. James Wilkes, 7. This is controversial,
I think. Yeah, so, I actually Well, I was talking to Bodie, and he said to pick Jonas, but I wanted Will Hubert. But I told Cooper to select Will Hubert, and he, for some reason, said Jonas Blight. But it has, even though it was a controversial pick, Jonas Blight has been very beneficial towards us, and it's probably up there with, you know, he's kicked a lot of goals for us this season, so.
He's been a cult hero out there.
He's back.
He actually does score some goals that really pisses off. Like, it's just those little tappings that just get here. Solid season, Jonas. So I'm 6.5.
Yeah. What's that put me on par with, Thomas?
It makes you better than Bo.
And Bo.
Oh yeah, that's changed.
Yeah, that is far.
He's leveled up.
I can't believe we didn't cheer.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on there, but hey, like Logan, he's been switching teams like a ball this season. He puts it in.
Best first touch in the league.
He's been pretty good for Heroes. I'll give it.
For some reason, he's been good in defence.
He's runs and goals.
He brings the enthusiasm, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's solid, like five. Yeah.
Five for Hubert. Nah, well done.
That's a steal.
I'd say his first half of the season was very good. Like,
yeah.
He's hard to defend, so he doesn't know what he's doing. But in saying, I reckon his second half of the season's been a bit.
It has been a bit worse than the start, but the first half was so good.
Last pick.
Yeah.
I'm willing to 7.
Yeah, I reckon 7.
For last pick.
Nah, well done, Jeff. For the draft, but we still have four more people to cover. We had a late comer from Western Australia. We welcome back. Welcome back, our friend Hero.
Yeah.
We welcome back Hero. He's
back
in the defending spot you love to defend.
He's out of
the
ball magnet.
He went to Heroes, which is a shame, but Nero was always there. He gets in the way of the attackers, he did his job well, and he copped about fucking 7 balls to the nuts. And that wiped him out for the rest of the day, but we'd love to have Nero back, and let's rate him a 10. And he's been around for the last few weeks. We've loved him a bit. Little Shocker O'Shaughnessy. We've loved him. Come on, boys, up and about. We met Shocker when playing against his grade in our little series that we did, and he traded over to us because he realised that we're absolute sick cunts. And he's been with us ever since, and we've absolutely loved him. Scores goals, saves goals.
True.
And yeah, that pulls.
What doesn't he do?
Yeah, he does a lot. And he gets up and down, which we love. He's really embraced the try-hard culture, so. Shocker.
That's an official 10.
What's a shocker? That's a 10.
I reckon he's an L.
Captains, we've got to get out first.
L. No players.
Well, we're not going to have anything lower than a 10.
Nah.
Yeah.
Realistically, Callum is the best player here. His skill is very good. His commitment to the game as a captain's a bit.
Pressure on trades. Yeah, I apologize, Heroes.
Yeah. Anyone else got anything to say about him?
Oh, this is pretty good.
Yeah,
that's got to get him some bonus points, sure.
10. Let me have it.
I'm
sorry. You can tell. You can tell he cares.
Logan, I have you gone.
Probably the biggest snub off from a player of the week. You've never quite got one. Snub.
Say it, please. Say it.
Being honest, at the start of the season, you're a bit of a cunt. But it was just showed your commitment and passion.
Probably caused like 3 cases of depression for division players, but nah, he's been
well,
great.
Well, apparently he's only a cunt because he cares about
he
wants his players to play better.
He's Draymond.
He's out there every day, pushing people to get better.
It's probably the
efforts of him.
I'll say it's probably the greatest captain in school soccer history, the way his termination is.
I'd agree. The amount of effort he puts into this
game. Same for your heroes when he tries.
Yeah. Oh, he
really
does.
Why'd you say that?
He just puts a lot of effort.
Thank you, Tessie. Thank you, man.
Get a number or what?
10.
Yeah.
As a captain.
Really? Yeah. Alright, hang on.
Really?
Except you go to about 1 when you're in keeper.
Yeah, we
go. 10 as a captain though. Oh. And as I
can tell this is the video.
Yes, thank you. Hope you enjoyed. It's been a great season. We've got plenty more to come next week. Grand final week. We're on the whole squad, yeah, there. Bigger team, cheer loud.